Now this sixth locus is in terms of conic sections. So suppose we have two points A and B, such that A is given by Z1 and B is given by Z2. And suppose there is a complex number, say P, which is given by Z. Now, if we are given that mod of Z minus Z1 plus mod of Z minus Z2, and it is equal to some positive real number K, then if this K is mod of Z1 minus Z2, then basically locus of Z is this line segment AB. And if this K is greater than mod of Z1 minus Z2, then in that case, we can write this as PA plus PB, it is equal to some constant K, which is focal property of ellipse. We need this condition because this K, in that case, will represent 2A, and mod of Z1 minus Z2, it will be distance between two focus, and it is 2AE. And we know that in case of an ellipse, value of E is always less than 1. So if K is greater than mod of Z1 minus Z2, then this Z, it will lie on this ellipse whose focus is at Z1 and Z2 and length of whose major axis will be equal to K. And if this K is less than mod of Z1 minus Z2, then it doesn't represent any locus. Now the seventh one is, if we have this condition that mod of Z minus Z1 minus mod of Z minus Z2 whole mod, and it is equal to K. Now this first case, when this K is equal to mod of Z1 minus Z2, we have already established that AP minus BP, it is equal to AB, then Z lies on straight line AB except for points lying between A and B. Now if K is unequal to mod of Z1 minus Z2, then we'll have this condition that mod of AP minus BP, it is equal to K, which is focal property of hyperbola. Now distance between focus is given by Z1 minus Z2, which is twice AE, and this K, it is 2A. And since for hyperbola E is greater than 1, then twice AE, it must be K. So in this case, this K, it must be less than mod of Z1 minus Z2. And if K is greater than mod of Z1 minus Z2, then again, it won't represent any locus. Now here the question is, if A is greater than 0 and if the equation represents an ellipse, then A lies in. Now we know that the equation mod of Z minus Z1 plus mod of Z minus Z2 equals K. It will represent an ellipse if K is greater than mod of Z1 minus Z2. Now in this case, value of K is 3. So the condition that we'll have is 3 must be greater than mod of Z1 minus Z2. Now Z1 is A square and Z2 is 2A. So we'll get A square minus 2A. Now when mod X is less than A, then X will lie between minus A and plus A. So from here we can write A square minus 2A will be greater than minus 3 but less than 3. Now if we solve this, we can write A square minus 2A plus 3, it is greater than 0. Now this is true for all A belongs to R. So this is always true. Now we have to solve the second part, which is a square minus 2a minus 3 is less than 0. So we can write a minus 3, a plus 1, it is less than 0. So we'll get minus 1 and 3. So this is plus, minus and plus. So the value of a must lie between minus 1 and 3. But it is given that a is greater than 0. So the value of a, it must lie between 0 and 3. And that's your option C. Now the question is, let eccentricity of ellipse with foci z1 and z2 be 1 by 3. So we have this ellipse whose foci are z1 and z2. And here the value of E is 1 by 3. Now it says mod of z1 minus z2 is 5. Now we know that mod of z1 minus z2 is distance between its focus. And distance between its focus is 2AE. So we can write 2AE equals 5. Now value of E is 3. So value of A is 15 by 2. Now we need to find maximum possible value of mod z minus z1. Now z, it will lie on this ellipse. Now we know that this distance will be maximum when it will lie here. Now this is A and this is AE. So maximum value of this modulus will be simply A into 1 plus E. Now A is 15 by 2 and 1 plus E is 4 by 3. So this is 5 into 2 and it will be simply 10. So maximum possible value of mod z minus z1 will be 10. Here the question is, if z be complex number on a complex plane satisfying mod z minus 0 minus mod z minus 6 plus 8 iota equals 10, then z represents what? Now here we can also write this as z minus 0 minus z minus 6 plus 8 iota, and it is equal to mod of 6 plus 8 iota minus 0. Now this is PA minus PB, and it is equal to AB. Now if PA minus PB, it is equal to AB, then this P, it lies on this ray, which is to the right of P. The option which is little close to that is a line, but basically it's not a line segment. Now here the question is, match the equation on the left with the curve they represent on the right. Now this first one, which is A, it is mod of z minus 3 plus mod of z minus iota equals 10. Now here the value of K is 10, and if we write mod of z1 minus z2, it'll be simply 3 minus iota, and which is under root 10. Now in this question, K is greater than mod of z1 minus z2. That means this equation will represent an ellipse. So this A, it matches with S. So this is S. Now for the second one, we are given that 2z minus 3 upon z minus iota equals 2. Now coefficient of z, it must be 1. So we'll take this 2 common. So we can write mod of z minus 3 by 2 upon z minus iota, it is 1. And if mod of z minus z1 upon z minus z2 is 1, then this z, it lies on a straight line. So this B, it matches with R. Now this third one is z square plus z bar square, it is equal to 5. Now this is x plus iota y square, and here will be x minus iota y square, and it is equal to 5. So we'll get this as 2 x square minus y square equals 5. So it'll be x square minus y square equals 5 by 2, which is nothing but a hyperbola, and that's your option Q. So the C, it matches with Q. Now what about D? Now D is mod of z minus z1 upon mod of z minus z2 equals 3. Now, since it is unequal to 1, that means this locus is a circle. So, this D, it matches with P. And that is the answer to this question.